Welcome back to Let's Play Hearts of Iron 4. This is the If at First campaign. April of 1945 now. And the Axis is doing pretty good, actually. Allies are still Britain and a bunch of miners. Belgium, Luxembourg, Ireland, Switzerland, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, the Raj. Sweden and Norway are neutral but at war with Britain. We declared war on them, and then Portugal's sitting here wondering what's gone wrong with the world. Portugal is currently a very tempting target. I'm trying to switch the ideologies of Brazil and the US so then I can go in kind of an endgame mode. I tried it with Britain, didn't work. I moved a little too early, perhaps. But it is what it is. Well, that's ugly. Let's see. Do it drawing a front without, like, having a seizure. Go for it. I guess they weren't fully in position yet. Oh well. I transfer troops to Sweden. I can't. Front. Send volunteers. So who would have thought the end of World War II would basically be a proxy war in Scandinavia? Isn't good. Get attrition out. The radar arrays, but I'd like to get some supply networks going too. And then, of course, in the middle of all this, I get messages. So, needless to say, I think I've equated myself far better than this time around than the previous two attempts. Which ultimately isn't saying all that much, since the previous two were kind of disastrous. Swedish volunteers. How Swedish it is. And I suppose I should have sent mountain troops up here. You know, I like Marines. That was quick. Wipe this pocket out. Turn north and deal with that big pocket. British. All right, this. There we go. You can stop coming through our territory. You can go around like everyone else. The real question is, does the Swedish AI have any chance of taking Gotland back? I'm skeptical. We shall see. The naval invasions are getting a little annoying. This basically turns the game into whack-a-mole. Everyone loves whack-a-mole. Said very few people. Now this should turn into a slaughter. I'm just curious, how is this war even going? Current wars. 100% in favor of the aggressors. Why would you say that? Weird. Okay. I mean, 1 million men have died fighting over Norway. It's crazy. This is getting moderately absurd, though. You can't swing a stick without hitting a British invasion fleet. Come on, guys. But yeah, I need to say it. the one concerning thing I have here is the speed at which the Allies drop new naval invasions. Come on, guys, you can do it. Gets that big long tech out of the way. Oh, and I sometimes I'm my own worst enemy. I didn't realize I had tech idling. Boo. Darren is a busy boy. He was brought in to throw another army back into the sea. Irish, Canadians, Australians. Is whack-a-mole. Not even the enjoyable kinds. Ship construction, shipyard. Wrong button. Okay. And we'll start building strategic bombers. Fighters throw, I do. Good. I always forget the little details. Makes life more interesting. I'm curious how they're pulling these off, because this should be closed. General officer that reduces attrition. But I did. I'm already using him. Oh yeah, I am already using him, okay. So now we're focusing nationally. First, you don't succeed. Invade again. Tech. Well, I've managed to fight back for Norway. Canada and that's where I did not. Oh, no, I am. Town. Come on, come on. I'd like to end this episode on a basically pristine Norway. Probably won't happen, but... The big problem I have is... Again, I'm out of manpower. Cancel the production of... Cancel the production of cavalry. Just sit on 500 manpower. Come on. There. I could end the episode with Norway cleaning of allies. In a permanent war, because Norway can't hurt Britain. Britain and the allies would send more troops. Oh, they'll only sort of all major faction members surrender. So you don't have to kill the little guys. You just have to kill the major faction members. Just saying. Let's see. Getting there. Alrighty, folks, well, thank you for watching, and the post-World War II aftermath, and we'll have more next time. Thank you.